Hey, it's Brianna, the entrepreneur with no job, but I do have a dream, and this is the journey. Today is day 130. And the last time I made an update, I was thinking about real estate wholesaling. I think in the video, I talked a little bit about kind of whatever was preventing me from taking action and feeling like I need to get to another level mentally where I am taking action. So I was thinking about that, and that night a couple of our friends came over, my husband and my friend, and we were talking about computers, and I was saying my husband was not gonna get a MacBook because the only reason I have a MacBook is for business purposes. And he said, "What business do you have?" I was a little bit offended because I've been talking about entrepreneurship for 130 days, but at the same time, I don't have anything that I'm like obviously working on, and I haven't made any money, so it's fair. But I did kind of explain what I was trying to do. I said I'm still trying to figure out what it is I'm doing. I started off with the blog, but it's just not really working out. And I recently started a YouTube channel, and I really like making videos. So he suggested I essentially do a documentary on Fort Bragg, which is where I live. And I was like, okay, I mean, that sounds like a good idea, but I also have less than 3 months here. How can I really do that? I don't have a camera, blah, blah, blah. We talked about it for a little bit. The next day, I was like, you know what? That sounds really good. Like, it sounds good and it feels good. When I think about any of the other things that I've considered, like list I made or I shared a few days ago, any of those things I think about, there's something in there. It's like I would have to overcome in order to complete it, like overcoming emotionally. But when I think about that project, it just sounds fun. Granted, there's no money attached to that, so maybe that's the difference. Like, it would be another hobby project, but at the same time, if the goal is to find my path, I think doing those things might help. I was listening to School of Greatness with Lewis Howell, and Charlemagne the God was on there, and Lewis asked, "What do you think greatness is?" And he said, "I think greatness is doing what you love." And that really resonated with me. I may have said that in a different video, but it did resonate with me. And I'm like wondering if that, even though it doesn't have money, maybe because I really want to find my greatness, maybe I should be doing that, or maybe I should pursue that. So that led me to the next question, which I actually talked to my mom about, like, how do I know if something's right? I felt the same about going to school. After I graduated with my undergrad, I was considering a master's. I looked into psychology. I actually met with a psychologist who's working on his PhD, and I like understood everything. I could see where I would work and all that, but or what kind of which branch I would go into, but I just didn't move forward because it just like something emotionally wasn't there. So I feel if, let's say, this is what I should do, this project, I do know that one of the differences is I feel excited about doing it. With blogging, I like writing because I like the fact that I like how people respond to it. Writing's not something that I just enjoy doing for the sake of doing it. And then any of those other things I like less than writing. I do like communicating and expressing myself, and I like performing. And I guess being on a video is a little bit of a performance, so maybe that's why I like it much better than writing. But when I think about Pampers Chef or Mary Kay, it's kind of like I have to overcome the fact that I have no emotional drive to do it. And I'm wondering if that's part of how you know if something is right for you, if you have some sort of emotional pull. And the last thing is, that other podcast I listened to called Join Up Dots, which I've mentioned before, Ralph says, or David Ralph, he says that there shouldn't be resistance. It should be like water, which is also a concept of law of attraction. Like, whatever is meant for you should just flow like water. Actually, I think Oprah said that too. So maybe that's why these other things aren't working for me, because there is resistance, because it's not meant for me. So that's day 30. Those are my thoughts. Constantly changing. I'm going to try to move forward on the video projects, but I'm still open, just kind of seeing what else feels good, what else flows off my back, I guess, or you know what I'm trying to say. Anyway, thanks for watching. Let me know if how you make decisions or how you know what's right for you. Last thing, I'm wearing my Bless sweatshirt that I ordered from Kev on Stage's Black Friday sale. Kev on Stage is a comedian on Facebook and YouTube. You should definitely look him up. All right. Peace and prosperity and productivity. I don't know. Thanks. Bye.